It's been so long since I've seen the original Wizard of Oz that I can only remember tidbits I've heard people sing of it in other shows, and whenever I've seen it, they're always singing If I Only Had a Brain.
Yeah, well, no, there are little bits and pieces of
so I thought it was just
reprises.
I thought it was just a Scarecrow independent song. I thought it's like
it's
she met the Scarecrow.
It
yeah, well, he's
song,
the first one she meets, right?
But
then they all sing it later,
yeah,
right?
Mm-hmm.
Bizarre. Yeah, I
there
guess
are,
makes
to
sense.
Use the correct term, reprises.
I think
right.
I remember them all singing it together, maybe, and then they were like toggling between. But maybe I'm imagining things.
No, I think you're right.
Yeah, like, you know, brain, heart, doodly booty dee.
I should probably introduce us now.
Yes, do it.
All right, so I'm the Hidden Object Guru. That was a clip from our other podcast, Musical Talk, where we talk about musicals, specifically The Wizard of Oz, over and over again. But seriously, that wasn't a stage musical first, was it? Like, it was an original musical created for the screen, right?
I believe so. Don't quote me on that 100%, but yeah, I believe that was the case.
Yeah, all right. So, I, of course, am the Hidden Object Guru. This is
The Night Dawg.
And we're here to play some Uncharted 4.
Yay! Pirates.
Hector Alcazar. So, here, to catch you up in the story, Nathan Drake, famous rogue,
mm-hmm,
has retired from Nathan Draking.
Right.
And his ne'er-do-well brother has returned from the ethers of never having been mentioned in any previous game. His suspiciously never-before-mentioned brother has made a reappearance.
I didn't know any of this. I had no idea. Are we starting from the beginning, or are we
we're not starting from the beginning.
No, okay, so you...
I streamed the first four chapters.
Oh, amazing. Okay, cool.
So what happens is there's a famous lost ship full of gold,
mm-hmm,
and when he and his brother were in their 20s, they went looking for it, and then they mishandled a prison break in the stupidest possible way, like
right,
an embarrassingly bad way. And his brother ended up in prison for the next 20 years.
Is this now his brother?
Yes, and his brother has become friend, has befriended,
mm-hmm,
a, ouch, has befriended a drug kingpin, you know, who continuously breaks out of prison, and an El Chapo type of figure.
Right.
Who apparently they just kept in a like he didn't have a special secured cell or anything, or he's literally just in a cell with this random gringo.
Amazing, you know, it's
and I guess they didn't like the gringo because he had been involved in the killing of the previous warden of the prison.
Right.
But at the same time, it seems like take a little more care with the guy. So now Sam, the brother of one,
Nate Drake.
Nathan Drake. So that makes him Samuel Q. Drake.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, nice. I've got the gun ready to go.
Ah.
Oh, and if you press reload while your gun doesn't have any ammo and you're zoomed in, you automatically switch to your other gun.
Oh, cool. That's
a
nice
really
feature.
Neat feature.
Yeah.
All right. So point is, this guy, get behind something. Done.
So I remember Drake being a street urchin, oh my goodness me, who was raised by his buddy Odo from Star Trek.
James Sully Sullivan.
That's right, James Sully Sullivan, yeah.
Yeah.
And so what's the deal with the brother? Like, how did they become, were they
well,
separated?
What happened
at some
was
point?
They were growing up in, I don't know, St. Croix or some place, some island
right,
in the Atlantic.
Right, right.
Caribbean, I guess, is the word I was looking for?
Yeah, in the Caribbean. Yeah,
in the
yeah,
Caribbean. At a Catholic orphanage.
Right.
And so what happens is... Oh, there was a gun. I'll just grab that. Thank you very much. And so he busted out, and his brother went to get a job smuggling drugs.
Okay.
There is so much button tapping in this game.
Yeah.
You have no idea. Got a job smuggling drugs or artifacts or something. They were
right,
being
right,
nebulous.
Okay.
And the brother never came back for ages. That's when he was a street... So, and he didn't go back to the orphanage.
Mm-hmm.
Instead, he just became a street urchin, which is when James Sully Sullivan met him.
Right.
Nice. And,
the rest is vague history.
Yeah. And I'm calling the brother Sam Drake, but of course, Drake is just a name he made up when he was a street urchin.
Yeah, they addressed that.
So,
the brother get
no, they haven't actually told us the brother's full name yet
right,
in the game. I'm killing a lot of people during
yeah,
this jailbreak.
Yeah, he invented the idea that he was a descendant of Francis
yeah,
Drake. Right?
Yeah,
that
that's
was,
all
yeah,
just a
yeah,
that's just all a make-em-up.
Mm-hmm.
Although there's a weird line early on in this game about the their mother having, you know, like expensive old stuff.
Okay.
And that they wanted to steal back stuff that belonged to her.
Oh, so maybe it's possible there's.
Maybe they do have some history with this.
This fellow looks slightly Bruce Willis.
I can see that.
Willis E.
Willisian, I think is the
term. Yes, Bruce Willisian.
Bruce Willsian. Bruce. Yeah, a lot of murder is my point.
Yeah.
And you may be saying, well, HOGuru, that's because you're playing with auto-aim on and you're just better at murder. But I feel like I would have to be murdering these guys anyway.
Oh, yeah. I mean, look, they're firing at you with machine guns. I see it being pretty doubtful that you get out of this situation without
I don't think I can count on my sidekicks to do all the murder. That's a bomb.
Yeah. And these guys are just prison guards that you're killing, or
just prison guards,
right? Whatever.
Yeah, like fine. I'm not the good guy in this scenario, you know. Like, and the thing is, like, there's this ridiculous, and I can't stress enough how ridiculous this situation is.
Yeah.
In the whoa.
Yeah, those concrete walks.
Yeah, I don't think those are gonna last long. Oh, he's automatically aiming at a guy. Nice. Well, all of the guys who came to get us out of here are getting murdered. Or, to use the proper vernacular, murthered.
Yes.
Oh. You're such a defeatist. Sam. I'm going to say Pilkington. I'm going to say their real family name is Pilkington.
Pilkington, yeah. You know, you might be right. Or maybe they haven't decided yet, and then, like, the next game, someone will have seen this, and they'll be like, hey, let's use Pilkington.
I think I got killed.
Oh, dang.
Do you want to take a shot at the
shooting? Oh, no, you go ahead. All right. I wanna see this play out. Right. Professionally.
Well,
how many levels are you in now? About
five.
Five levels in. Yeah, it's best to. All
right. Whoa! I enjoyed that animation.
That was nice.
All right, so let's murder some people. And here's the big question.
Mm-hmm.
Your thoughts on the Nathan Drake situation?
Okay, my thoughts on
him as a person.
Oh, you mean is he like a criminal scumbag?
Yeah. Is he a criminal scumbag? I don't think I was supposed to go forward yet, because it just, nobody even shot me, I just automatically died.
You know, it's been like a few years since I played the last games, I played them all in close succession, and I really enjoyed them, and I'm trying to remember what the most immoral thing is that he might have done in the game, on screen and not vaguely implied. I mean, we know he's a bit of a rogue and into the theft and such, but I don't think I remember him ever killing anyone who didn't deserve it.
Oh, no, not at all. Like, I don't think he's a terrible human being or anything, but at the same time, he is a guy who, I was supposed to wait for that to happen, apparently. Helicopter? Do we have a helicopter? No. How do I put this? I like him, but at the same time, he is pretty casual about murdering. Dozens, even hundreds of people.
I'm just remembering, and this raises the issue, too, of, like, in a lot of games, you have this kind of weird bifurcation of, like, the narrative, you know what
yes.
I mean? Like, where it's like, here's the thing that's happening, and it's happening in, you know, the cinema sequences or whatever, and therefore you understand that it's meant to have actually happened in the story.
Whereas all of this stuff is just, you
it's
know,
like singing in a musical, you know, like, you're meant to imagine it's like, this is a way of presenting something to you that's happening or whatever, right? And it's like sometimes the playability in a video game feels like that. It's like, you clearly killed a bunch of guys.
To escape.
But then it's like, it's treated like, oh, well, maybe you just shot him in the leg. Though you clearly didn't.
I shot a lot of people in the face escaping.
Yeah, and I know that's an odd, like, I'm trying to think of some good examples of this. I was returned to Grand Theft Auto and stuff that would happen in those games where there's
especially
like,
San Andreas.
Yeah, San Andreas. Where's the main story missions. And those clearly are actually meant to have happened in the narrative. And then there's the kind of side stories that aren't that important.
Although even, even in that one.
Yeah. And the one I always go back to is where you bury a foreman to death in a porta potty, in his own feces, we assume.
Yeah.
Almost certainly killing him. I mean, he's definitely going to die.
He calls himself Samuel Drake, too.
Oh, weird. So what, did they both agree
on? I guess they both agreed on the fake name.
Oh, maybe beforehand. Yeah, maybe they decided it to keep each other sane in the orphanage. They decided that they were descended of...
Oh, and he broke him out of jail because he promised him he would know where the treasure of... was.
What is the treasure of in this?
Oh, it's just a famous treasure ship that a pirate captain stole and
They're
then it sank.
They're usually real-ish.
It is a real one. Yeah. Avery's treasure. Captain Avery's treasure.
So I wonder, do you think, from my memory of the previous games, I don't think there was any magic yet, right? It was always ends up being scientific-y, kind of, slightly,
not really
sort
of. Scientific-y. I mean, there was a Shangri-La.
Oh, no, I know there was, but I mean, they weren't Bigfoot men.
Orcs.
After all, they were guys dressed up as Bigfoot men.
They were orcs who dressed as Yeti. They were still orcs.
So were they people who had been altered by like a fountain of youth that was there or something?
That's exactly what it was.
So there was a fountain of youth.
Yeah.
And so it doesn't really matter whether or not we call it a sciencey fountain of youth or not. The fact is there was a liquid that if you drank, you could live forever, right?
And then when they went to the Oasis of the Pillars or whatever it was called.
Yeah.
It was just LSD.
Yeah. And the zombies was a kind of fungus that Aztecs had discovered, or a virus or something, or
it was a instantly mind breaking virus.
Yes, that was it. Yeah.
Oh crap.
Oh my god. It turns into monkey zombies, I think.
Yeah. And then they interbred and became interbred monkey zombies.
Oh yeah, so they were inbred.
And they were all troglodyte looking things.
Right, right.
So here's how they got into trouble.
Mm-hmm.
6 months? That's
incredibly
reasonable.
Graphically, really, it is.
For finding treasure.
They always ask for more time than they actually need. 3 months.
3 months is a
3 months. Half the treasure. Can you do it?
See, here's my question here.
Mm-hmm.
3 months. Half the treasure.
I feel like this guy is not making the best plan.
Mm-hmm.
The
drug lord, you mean?
No, yeah.
Or criminal, or whatever he is.
Both of them.
Yeah.
Because, here's the thing, I hate to say it, mm-hmm. you're just a Panamanian drug lord.
Yeah, his reach isn't infinite,
it's
really.
It's really not that bad. I don't think Noriega is the guy that could kill you in Scotland.
Yeah.
Because they have probably to go to not. Scotland, there was a church in Scotland that Avery supposedly left a clue at.
Okay.
And I'm like, I don't know if the game's actually going to go there, but whatever.
All right.
But I don't know that a Panamanian drug lord is going to be a big problem.
No.
You, a white guy with cash and no papers, I assume you'll have no trouble getting from Panama to Louisiana, right?
I mean, maybe he really likes hanging out in Panama. He wants to have that as an open option. Real bad.
When the time comes, I'll be there tomorrow.
By the way, I love that he's both going to have to battle this guy's army of goons.
Right.
And presumably the army of goons owned by the guy who was paying for their first attempt to find this treasure 20 years ago.
Okay. Oh, so they went on treasure adventures together as
young
men. So what's your opinion of Drake in terms of
I think he's fine. And he looks a lot more like Nathan Fillion than he used to.
I was going to say, actually, he does, doesn't he?
Now that they've gone for a super realistic face, they based it on Nathan Fillion, quite obviously. I think he's an okay guy, and I may do an article about this, but I think he's the worst tomb raider / archaeologist / grave robber in the world.
Okay.
And I'll tell you why.
Uh-huh.
Because in every single game, the thing that he's searching for turns out to be something completely different.
Mm-hmm.
So a giant sapphire turns out to be the Tree of Life.
Yeah.
A golden city turns out to be a golden man with a biological weapon.
Yeah.
A magical fountain turns out to be, you know, that magically destroys a city.
Yeah.
Turns out to be an LSD virus bomb.
Right.
Right?
Just the St. Dismas cross.
And the thing is, the other people shooting at the treasure all knew the thing it was going to turn out to be.
Yeah, so he himself is quite ill-informed.
He had no idea what it was going to turn out to be, but in every case, the other person knew what it was going to be. There's a second.
The level of realism is quite fascinating.
It looks great, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. That's really realistic looking sweater. I know, that's an odd thing to get. The denim, not so much. Still realistic looking, but, you know, not as much as the sweater.
We're going to have to rob a
Did his brother have bird neck tattoos? Because, like, when they were young, they would look up and they would see the birds flying over, and that was freedom, and then
I think it's just a jailhouse thing.
Oh, okay. I thought there'd be a story about that at some point, maybe. He wanted to be free like the birds.
I could take a second mortgage out on my house, and it still wouldn't be enough.
He has a house.
We're gonna, yeah. Well, he made a lot of money tomb raiding in those games.
Yeah, of course. He told me he retired.
Yeah.
Did he? Which of his female counterparts did he marry?
The non thief one.
Yeah, I figured that would make sense.
Oh man, listen, I can't. I'm out. What?
See, he's out.
I just don't do that kind of thing anymore.
Besides, there he's a scrap diver.
Ah, okay.
He does salvage work by diving.
Huh.
I don't know. Like, anybody? Charlie Cutter?
No.
No, he's my go-to guy
for
this.
Absolutely not. I don't trust Charlie or anybody else.
So when is Sully back in this game?
Oh, has Sully not appeared yet?
No.
Ah, I hope he's not dead or something. That would suck.
Well, his buddy in this business has found a treasure thing.
Mm-hmm.
And there's got to be another way. And he wants Nate to go along looking for it.
You know, this is exactly what I knew would happen, and I'm not complaining at all. Yeah. That if we play this game, unlike other ones, and maybe this is a better method. I don't know.
Okay.
But normally we talk about unrelated nonsense.
Yes, we do.
But these are engaging games where I care about the characters. And,
as well, you should.
That kind of thing. You know,
Yeah, it's me.
Yep.
Yeah. Listen, you're not gonna believe this.
Turns out my brother's alive. Jameson just walked in here with permits. Oh, he's lying to his wife.
Ooh.
Yeah.
It's gonna blow up in his face.
It's like I'm gonna take that Malaysia job after.
God damn it, Nathan Drake.
Oh man.
What are you doing, lying to your
like
perfectly
Daredevil
reasonable wife?
Lying for no reason.
Daredevil does love to lie to people, doesn't he? Yeah. Like that's his major way of interacting with the world, is lying to everyone.
That's one of his powers that he got.
Which is, I guess, why he became a lawyer! I'm a terrible person.
That show was pretty clever. Well, nice cars.
They are.
And no sign from Sullivan yet.
Hmm, so he will be here.
So he did call Sully.
Yeah.
Finally.
Thank God.
It's like the storage room's in the building behind the manor. You see it from up there?
Oh, they're gonna rob an auction. It is a very... Wow, they spend all of this money to get the everything about their video game realistic, and then they have the ridiculous cartoon binocular effect, which is believed by people who have never looked through a pair of binoculars.
Yeah.
You know, Breaking Bad is the only show I've ever seen that had a realistic binocular in it.
Binoculars, yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's become kind of like standard for now. It's just kind of accepted. Like, it would be disappointing if it wasn't the silly movie binocular.
I didn't see anyone complaining when it happened on Breaking Bad. Like, people wrote in letters, why didn't his binoculars have a ridiculous foof in the middle of them?
Well, you know, I miss flashback.
I miss that, too.
Yeah, I miss that.
But, again, that's something that, you know, is a cinematic effect representing something.
Not an
happening.
Attempt to accurately visually simulate,
yeah.
You know. But when I think about things that I've done in the past, that actually, that's what I see. I see.
Oh, apparently his name was Victor Sullivan.
Oh, Victor Sullivan.
Not
yeah.
James Sully Sullivan. Vic Sully Sullivan.
But I trust him, all right? He's family.
He really is.
Or is he?
Oh. Yeah, because we thought he was going to betray him that one time.
Yeah, I didn't believe it for a second, though.
I don't think...
That was the least believable fake betrayal I've ever seen in a video game.
Yeah.
Okay. Nathan.
Dude, at least just for one second, consider the possibility.
There.
See, it's Troy Baker as, there we go.
I just want to remind everyone that these games are much better than Crystal Skulls was a movie.
Oh, God, yeah. Not even close.
Yeah.
I mean, they're worse than every Indiana Jones movie.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, yeah. Except for Crystal Skulls, which doesn't count.
Except for Crystal Skulls, which is the worst Indiana Jones movie, and every one of these games has been better than Crystal Skull.
Yeah.
I'd put them all about the level of a National Treasure.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Is that damning with faint praise?
You know, it's hard to say, because in some ways, we, you know, National Treasure, maybe it's kind of, you know, chintzy in some ways, but it also has Nicolas Cage, which is always entertaining. So
here's the problem that they got into. So they were going into the this jail to look for this cross,
right.
And they had the guy in charge of the jail.
Mm-hmm.
And by the way, and I want to point out, this guy is just the warden of a jail in Panama.
Okay.
And he's like, I figured out what treasure you're looking for.
Right.
Boom. So I want 1/4 of the treasure money.
Right.
If this thing you found in my jail leads you to the treasure.
Right.
Which, by the way, they're looking for $400 million worth of treasure.
Yeah, so giving him 1/4 of that is pretty small pittance considering, you know,
more to the point,
help, you know.
He doesn't know the exact amount they're looking for. So literally they could say, guess what, buddy? We found $100 million worth of treasure.
Exactly.
Here's your $25 million, and how would he ever know?
Yeah, yeah.
But he won't even know if they ever find it or not, because they're illegal treasure looker forers.
Now, was he also using a kind of a carrot in the stick thing where he was like, I'm going to arrest you for breaking into this jail?
No, he got them into the jail, and he was
really?
Just supposed to get them out.
He was just really perfectly fair.
They were already paying him, and that's why one of them was such a dick about it.
Yeah.
So here's the issue. Which button is... Is it bad that I've already forgotten which button is grappling hook?
Oh, gosh.
That's bad, right?
Don't worry, just keep trying until you get it. So
yeah,
you gotta snag
be
that
one of
rope
these
oh my goodness me.
Okay, that scared me too much. All right, so grappling hook.
There we go.
Ah, it's not dive roll. Because they're saying L3, but L3 just turned me towards it with the camera.
I love it when adventurers...
Oh, I had to hold down the button. I didn't have the grappling hook yet.
Oh. Whoops.
Watch this.
There we go.
Yeah, he finally got a grappling hook.
Nice. Whoosh, 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 ooh.
Because he hasn't done it in a while, you see.
It's all in the wrist.
There we go.
Ah, nice.
Yeah, it's not bad.
All right. Oh, so, my, as I was saying, so, and this is whenever he starts reaching... it's safe to do your little jump.
Oh, my God.
And you may ask, hey.
You see that?
That was awesome.
Oh, like a pro. It's your turn.
Oh. Yeah. So, obviously, and the... So, their buddy, their crazy buddy who was putting up for the money, mm-hmm. his response is, interesting plan. How about instead I stab you to death?
Oh, no.
So, he stabs the guy to death.
Making things
in
really
his office, in the middle of the prison.
Wow, that's
so
really
A,
stupid.
The guy's not asking for anything unreasonable, and you can give it to him without actually giving it
B,
to him,
B, this
right?
is the worst possible way to deal with that
But the
situation.
Best part is, he was in the process of getting ready to take you out of the prison
yeah.
To get you to a boat.
Forcibly trapping you in the prison now as criminals, yeah.
All right, so I have to jump away
so
from the
So you can escape
wall.
By murdering the guards, who really are just doing their job. I mean, I know like the attitude is like, oh, they're in a country we consider... potentially nefarious, and so it's okay to shoot these prison guards or something, but, you know, no come on.
Yeah. No, you're right. It's pretty...
have prisons in Panama, too.
Yeah.
Like, right. all the guards are scumbags. Okay. Well, maybe they are. I have no idea. Maybe we can assume that they all were, and somehow these guys knew that, and therefore it was morally okay.
I really doubt it.
Yeah, there's, like...
no, but seriously, like, even yeah. if... Oh. Even if... Mm-hmm. Okay. Wait, we can do this. Mm-hmm. Swing, yeah. swing.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, Nathan Drake, you're the best.
Yeah.
Okay, boom. Hold up. What's happening?
Oh, my God.
Oh, no, it's murderers.
Yipes.
It is a criminal auction, so.
Oh, it's a criminal auction, ah.
Well, criminal adjacent.
Yes, yes, of course.
Okay, that was close.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Or was it? No, it wasn't. Yeah, but like the guy was in the process of getting ready to take them to their boat.
Yeah.
If you're going to stab him after you've escaped.
Exactly.
We're going to pull this off so smoothly we won't need him.
Aw.
I hope you're right.
So, here's the important question. Did you listen to all of Hamilton yet?
Oh, no, I didn't get to. I had to do a whole bunch of chores and crap like that. I'm sorry. I started listening to the very first song, the rap, and it was quite good.
It is good.
Yes.
The rest of it is even better.
I'm sorry, we will talk about it next week.
Next instead. Week, after you've had time to hear all of Hamilton. Dumb. Because it's something else. All right.
So it's brand new then, as of what, this year? Or
last year.
Last year.
Yeah, this year is when it won the Pulitzer Prize.
Wow.
But,
I didn't even know they gave Pulitzer Prizes for musicals.
They usually don't.
Oh, because it's
that's
good.
How good it is.
Damn. I'm like far too happy that it's teaching people about history. Like when I started listening to the rap and it's like talking about his life in rap form.
Yeah. It's pretty amazing.
I'm always pleased when, I don't know. I care about historical education.
Well, here's something we'll talk about
forms.
After you've seen it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, tell me about it. Because after you've heard all of it,
so, yeah.
Because I want to get into the conversation of, mm-hmm. am I this impressed with it?
Yeah.
A, because it's just because it is, like, the best musical you'll ever hear in your
life. Right,
right. Or am I also, how much does it weigh in?
Mm-hmm.
I wish. Elena filmed some of it, but Cameron didn't.
Oh, yeah, the first one. Okay. The first adventure.
Yeah.
Some drawings, though. When we get back, I'll show you.
You have drawings?
Huh?
Are they up on the fridge or something?
No, such a dick.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go. All right. Or, like, is it just that it's the best musical, which it is,
yeah.
or is it also mm-hmm. that all of this stuff actually happened?
And that's what makes it so entertaining.
Like, is that, you know, does that make us love it more?
I bet that's a factor. I would
yeah.
I would guess. Because
if this was the story
you know,
of
just a goddamn
Jake, Jake Frangeman,
right.
who, you know, moved to the country of Glyphnar and became the Flumden of Rasmalin.
Like, I'm sure the songs would still be entertaining to you if you like the tunes.
But it would have the same kind of
saying.
Impact if it wasn't teaching us about history.
Yeah, but obviously it's like when it's like something, and this is what I hated about, like, I'm glad they're doing good musicals again.
Yeah.
Because it's like what had happened is they used to do really awesome musicals, you know, Phantom of the Opera, Les Mis, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
And then at a certain point, they started saying, let's take awesome songs by bands and singers that people like.
And just awkwardly put it together into a musical.
Yeah, and that's those are great songs, but that's not a great musical. Because the craft of doing a good musical is you take a story, and then you show your skill by saying, look, I took all these elements of the story, like, you know, Phantom of the Opera did, let's say, or Mulligan, you know, Les Mis. These are all novels, right? And then and then you structure a song around the content of that novel. And then people are like, oh, so what, you know, masterful skill that took to do, right? Like, you weren't allowed to just freeform make up whatever you want or whatever, right? And
I don't know which way. Oh,
here we go. Oh,
you can do it.
Yeah, and then what started happening is then talented Hollywood people had to start coming in and doing good jobs for Broadway, and a lot of that stuff was like kind of comedy or parody. Well, I you can't really say that Producers was exactly a parody of musicals, or I guess the original movie is.
It's a parody of a kind of musical.
Because there's humor coming from the fact that, you know, Producers was already a semi musical movie, because a movie about a musical or whatever.
It's a movie about a musical. Yeah,
but there's the comedy that's coming from the fact is like here's
a
musical.
Yeah, I thought you meant the movie. I'm crazy. Yeah. No, the musical is not a parody of musicals. It's just a musical.
Here's a musical about a horrible thing, though, right? Which is sort of funny or whatever, right? Like in the same with the craziness of Book of Mormon or whatever, right?
Yes, it's, exactly.
You know, they got the comedy element as well. And I know musicals can have comedy in them and so on, but now here's a musical that's just a story about a historical figure with awesome songs. So
where were their jackets?
$400 million. Were they wearing them under those suits? Because that would be really uncomfortable. Unless they had them tied around their waists.
Maybe.
And we didn't see that under the boiler.
Hey, uniform. it's some sort of Sully.
Ah.
Victor Sullivan.
What I love about partying with a bunch of crooks.
What's that?
Nobody cares if you're smoking.
Oh.
God bless you, Odo.
It's been a while.
It's amazing that you haven't been killed by your cancer yet.
Remember my dead brother, right?
Is he going to punch him?
No. 15 years.
Yep.
Oh. Good
to see you alive soon.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, I guess he decided on the Drake thing together.
Yeah, I guess.
Which is fine.
Yeah, because I mean, when he first met him, he already was obsessed with Drake, right? He was trying to steal that ship from the museum. Or,
yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
When he was
oh, no, but I'm just saying, the two kids.
They must have decided in the old...
In ye olden days.
Yeah. Orphanage.
It's the cross!
There it is. Just like in Last Crusade, he was looking for an old-timey, expensive crucifix.
Yep.
Well, how long before they start the bidding?
15 minutes tops.
What can we possibly do in that amount of time?
We can grab it.
There is just a small matter of a few hundred.
Oh, what if we shot everybody? That's what we normally do in these games.
Apparently,
we shoot everybody.
Yeah.
Like,
fire alarm. An actual fire.
Mm-hmm. But there's got to be something.
The gods see us making for that cross.
Get a bunch of people to eat beans and.
Jesus, you guys act like you never spend time in prison. If you want something dirty done, then you wait
for
lights
out. Yeah. Where's that electrical panel for this place?
It can't be that hard to find. Oh, he brought the map with him. That's nice.
The breakers.
That's it up here. So we just have to climb up there and kill the lights. Grab the cross in the dark.
There will be an emergency generator.
That'll give us a few seconds of darkness to work with.
Meaning we'll have to be right next to the cross when the lights go out.
There's no way we can get that close without being noticed.
Scusate, signor.
Without being a waiter.
Mose.
Hi. How are you?
Apparently he's a devilish rogue and seducer of women.
Yes. Or at least imagined himself that way.
Yeah, she might not have cared. It's hard to say.
Good work.
Though, for plot purposes, it might turn out she did. So he can, I don't know, try on her uniform, which would be too small for him. So probably
that's definitely not what he's doing.
No.
All right.
Keep your eye on the prize, okay? Let us know if anything kinky goes down.
Roger that.
They are adorable.
Got this. Ready?
Oh, games about heisting.
Follow me.
You just make me happy.
Yeah.
All right, so now we just have to do the things that he said. Doing a little push through people animation. Mm-hmm. He says, excuse me, because he's a polite dude.
Yeah.
Nate, you're the best. All right, so which?
A drawing room.
Yeah. Let's head downstairs. Hey, buddy. That was a weird way to dodge people.
Yeah,
I feel like he turned the wrong way.
That might have been a minor glitch.
Now he's got a weird going downstairs animation on Sully. Mm-hmm. Oh, what's this?
Some kind of documentation.
Rossi State Auction, Chin Sing Holding Chinese, Terracotta Soldiers, JR Acquisitions. Who owns the, trying to find out who owns the, what do you call it?
All cross?
Final. Yeah, the cross.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I see. You can do this.
Okay. Yeah, but it's like, why would you have to when you can just do this? Yeah.
Don't you wish, like, even realism notwithstanding, that it was just a piece of paper that had very clear instructions of what they want you to do next in block letters?
That,
like,
would be nice. Go downstairs.
Yeah.
Follow Sully to basement.
Yeah.
Charing Cross Bridge by Claude Monet. Yeah, I don't think it's here. Oh, well, that's fine.
Okay. Maybe there are
There are two pages. Okay. They specifically said there were two pages.
Okay.
Oh, we may have lost. Oh, there he is.
Mm-hmm.
Sally's just through there. Let's go.
Yes, let's see if we can see repeating faces in the crowd.
A nice sculpture. Cool.
Of course they play douchey European techno.
Of course they are playing douchey European techno.
Did I just change who I was following? I did.
You're following your brother now. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh well.
When did that happen?
I don't know.
Okay, we can do this. Oh yeah, here. Yeah, just watch me. Oh, we were all going the same way.
I see.
Hell, it's locked. It was open earlier. Now what? Can we pick it? No, it's electronic. We don't have to find another way in.
Or just step away while it opens.
Yeah, so shit's really lost its cachet now, eh?
What?
Like, seeing shit. It's like it's in everything now. They're like, yeah. Oh, shit, what are we going to do? Like Spider-Man, I think, said it in the new Captain America.
He did, didn't he?
It used to be a big deal in that video release, Transformers, the animated movie, that
they could actually swear.
Shit, they said, in reference to Unicron eating that moon. Right. Holy shit, what are we going to do now? Swear that wasn't in the film when I saw it in theater. Yeah.
You think they might have added that later?
I've always wondered, did they add it later, or the rumor I heard is it was edited from the original theatrical release?
Pickpocketing mode.
It really felt like another voice had been inserted, so I don't know.
Yeah. Why aren't we just letting him do it? He's the criminal who's been in jail for decades.
Yeah, I thought we were told he was the best pickpocket, or was he
they
saying
specifically
that?
Specifically, just said that. Oh.
Yeah. So why is he expecting you to do it other than gameplay ability?
I think it'd be gameplay ability, which is weird because we were just playing.
I know
as,
it's not like you can't and aren't going to continue playing as
Sam in the other chapter.
Yeah. I don't know. Yeah. Maybe.
Come on. That was smooth. Smooth as silk.
Yeah.
Or at least smooth
polyester.
As lace.
Yeah. Lace is
Wait,
very
it's
not smooth.
The opposite of smooth, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah.
Well, we all saw what I did.
Yeah.
All right, here we go.
Professionals at work. Okay.
Nice. All
right.
That was the other door that opened. You know what? I wasn't paying that close attention.
Need these.
Yay! Ear radios.
Nice.
High-tech ear radios that aren't being jammed by this criminal thing.
Good luck.
I wonder at what point his wife is going to have to come in and save him.
I think now. Next chapter?
Yeah, probably a little later. Like
she still
Scotland
thinks he's looking for Malaysia.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, what happens when his boss from the salvage company calls the house and
is
like, hey, what's going on with him? And I mean,
maybe he's taking care of that off-screen.
Hands in the
oh,
air.
There we go.
Oh, no, it's a lady. The lady we haven't
Pleasure
met.
To see you again.
Only this time, I've got the drop on you.
Sadly, they did flashbacks in this one, and we didn't get any more Steve Valentine.
No,
I know.
Yeah. You know how it is.
Big fan of Steve Valentine.
Once in a while, a job requires us to get all dolled up. Looking sharp, by the way.
Not too bad yourself.
They really would rather be making movies, wouldn't they?
They would. They're so realistic, baby.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the thing about the people in these games, is they look like actual people.
Oh,
you know?
Yeah. I mean, it's all motion captured, so.
You know what I mean? Like, your faces aren't as minimalist. Or the faces are motion captured, too. Okay.
Yeah, the facial expressions.
Okay. Oh, the expressions, okay. Yeah.
I mean, it's not an actual video. They just have a camera right here in front of your face and dots all over your face while
course,
you talk.
Yeah.
I'm
just trying to buy you a drink. Ross. Hey, doesn't she own that army for
There home? We go.
Ah.
Coastline?
Shoreline.
Yeah. That's right.
Shoreline.
Heartless mercenaries.
Yeah.
It's putting it mildly. Fortunately,
It's like silver sable.
Yes, though she was a leader of a country, wasn't she?
Oh, maybe. Yeah, but she also had a mercenary army.
She did.
They were mercs. They were merc-sized Telsias.
See, they're telling us it's going to be okay to kill all these guys because they're mercenaries. Yeah,
that's
all
right.
Which, I mean, from a moral standpoint, is accurate.
Okay. Yeah.
No, I mean, if you've accepted money to kill people,
sure.
You are now...
pretty
like,
bad.
Well, no, but you
unless
are,
you're like
you
a
have
good
taken
mercenary
yourself.
That only kills bad people that they've done a deep moral background check on, like, you know, one of those fictional kinds of mercenaries
yeah,
that don't
you know.
Exist.
Yeah, but once you start accepting money to kill people,
yeah, you're basically
done. You've set aside your own place in the moral order.
Yeah,
like you are. It is killing you becomes a morally neutral act.
Exactly,
because you are someone for whom life has no intrinsic value.
Yeah, especially if they're coming after you already, right?
Yeah. No, so if a mercenary
I'm
is shooting
it's going to happen at some point.
Oh, yeah. But I'm just saying, I'm not even going to have a problem stealth-killing mercenaries in this game, because, you know.
This is what they signed up for when they became murderers for hire.
They're murderers for hire. Yeah. That's the job.
Yeah.
Like, oh?
No, I suppose you could argue that since you murdered all those prison guards in a quest to get treasure.
Oh, no, I don't think we're good people.
No. You're part of that shady world of people who are allowed to kill each other and no one will care. You
know? I think the guards' families probably care.
Yeah. No, I didn't mean the guards. I mean you and your brother. And
no, Sully. I would not. I would not make that argument. I think we should definitely hold these guys morally responsible for their actions.
Yeah.
And I think when he was telling Nathan the story just then, he in real life probably glossed over all the dead guards.
Yeah, probably.
We played it, but I think that didn't factor too heavily into his story. That looks like a fake wall to me.
Yeah. I wonder if you're going to have to use the wine to blow a hole in the wall. That happened to MacGyver once.
It did?
In a very similar situation. He was also, I think, in Latin America.
You know, new MacGyver TV show.
No.
Yeah. MacGyver Jr. has his own TV show.
Oh, I heard that they were going to do a MacGyver Jr. show, and I didn't know.
They almost did 10 years ago, and now it's finally happening.
Wow. So is Richard Dean Anderson going to be in it as MacGyver Sr.? Or
I think he'll... I mean, unless he's dead in the show... I assume he'll show up at some point.
Maybe they'll play it as him being... Hey, was the final episode of MacGyver, like, he finds his son or something?
Yep.
So is it going to be that kid?
No. That guy's 45 now.
Yeah, I was going to say that guy be like, he wouldn't be a young guy.
It's a different MacGyver Jr. And the really weird part about it is...
Right.
That, like, it's not a show about MacGyver going around doing things. Mm-hmm. Remember how when they did the new Knight Rider, they're like... Let's fill it with 18 cast members.
Yeah.
Because what Knight Rider needed was a giant cast.
It needed a giant ensemble cast and terrible reworking of the music. These are the things that
and they don't know how to do a show that doesn't have a giant ensemble cast anymore.
Oh, yeah. That's become the format for people coming out of TV writing school.
Yeah. It's like, no, you need 9 characters on your show. And so it's not MacGyver going around doing thing. It's George Eads from CSI is a spy of some kind, a freelance spy, and he's partnered with this crazy kid MacGyver who's always doing nonsense.
Yeah, that's all it was. There was literally only 2 cast members to MacGyver for a long time. Like, they had recurring characters like his buddy and Terry Hatcher and so on. But even they didn't appear
in every episode.
Exactly. Like, you could probably count on
most of the episodes. Dana Elkar, famous blind man.
That's right, as he would become. Yeah,
would say, "Hey, Mac, this is what you got to do this week."
I swear to God, I still haven't got through the entire run of MacGyver, which I have on DVD.
Yeah.
But the first season, maybe even the first season and a half, it is unclear what he even, like, who he even works for.
He
works
for the CIA in the first season.
Yeah, they don't even, like, they show him doing CIA jobs occasionally, but then sometimes he'll be doing other stuff that doesn't seem CIA.
No, but in the first season, yes, they were fast and loose with the kind of jobs he did, but he was employed by the CIA.
That's right, and then eventually, he just became part of this Phoenix Foundation, which really never fully got explained, like, what it was and where it came from, other than it was, like, a freelance...
intelligence
think tank,
clearing
yeah,
house,
composed
think
of
house.
Yeah, people who had been in the intelligence industry, but also in sometimes it did other things too. Like, you know, we've come up with a new environmental machine, machine for helping the environment. I don't know
who was picking up the tab.
Yeah,
at the Phoenix Foundation was never 100% clear.
Yeah, like, was it just donors, or is it like partly government funded, or what?
Or do they like? Oh. Guess we're going to have to murder him and steal his costume.
I think so, yeah. Murdering them is the only option. In real life, it would, because knocking people out, I assume, is really hard. Like, knocking a guy out without causing permanent brain damage.
Yeah.
I mean, maybe you can put him in a sleeper hold. Is that a thing? Or is that
just you know, you're 50-50 going to kill somebody if he's a sleeper hold. It's not
all
a
these things
thing
I want to do, and they're all like, you know, people will die if you do them. And I believe that, like, too readily.
Include the
anyway,
list
anyway.
Of things you want to do is put a sleeper hold on somebody.
And steal their tuxedo to break into some kind of swanky, you know,
high-end party. Of course that's something you know, if you bought a screwdriver along with you, this would be easier.
Yeah.
Or a wrench. All right. Alley oop indeed.
Yeah.
But yeah, so now they'll be like, so they'll be MacGyver and George Eads.
Yep.
And they'll be a lady they work with.
Right.
And they'll have a boss. And they'll probably have at least one or two technical people who also work there.
Oh, wow.
And it's like, so before you know it, like, you're going to have this ridiculously large cast.
No. I hope there's not
drawing
some guy
focus from
always
MacGyver
sitting on a computer and being like, oh, MacGyver, I'm hacking and helping you. Like, I'm getting a little bit tired of I'm hacking and helping you. And I understand the necessity of having a healthy hacker. It's just that, like, every show has a
healthy
hacker.
You really, there is no necessity for that.
Well, you know what I mean? Like, nowadays, oh, there's a lot of computers and blah, blah, blah. And you're going into a facility, some guy's got to hack, and then he'll turn off the cameras or something or whatever.
Yeah, but I mean, you can do that without showing the character.
I know. We don't have to see that person. You're right. They could just be like this backup. They don't have to be a recurring character. It could change every several weeks.
Fun fact about the real-life FBI. The people, the people who work, sorry, case officers, guys who actually investigate things, never meet or talk to the technical agents.
Oh, really?
So the computer hackers and the surveillance people.
Oh, fascinating.
Do you know why?
Why is that?
Because if the case agents knew who they were, then when they're invariably in court, they could be asked to say who they were.
Excellent.
And everything the FBI does is so illegal.
Right. Plausible deniability is what
so
you're saying.
So no technical agents' name ends up on anything. So it really gives you an interesting look at Criminal Minds. Because every week on Criminal Minds, they're like, oh, we think the killer might be epileptic. And then their computer is like, don't worry, I'll just search everyone's medical records in America.
Yeah, they're always doing this. I don't watch Criminal Minds. I just watch these terrible shows like Arrow, where it's not being done by a government agency.
But in that, it's the exact same, same kind of thing.
Yeah.
So it's hugely illegal, and the FBI is doing it. And the weird part is, in real life, they actually do that.
Oh, yeah, I know.
They just, you know, conceal it.
By making the plausible deniability of the case agent doesn't know, Wow.
Well, do you want to hear the crazy thing?
Yeah.
So apparently the FBI can, like, to within a foot, tell you where any cell phone is on Earth.
Yeah, I know, triangulation and all this stuff.
But it's a new technology beyond triangulation.
Oh, okay. Right? So within a foot,
Within, like, anywhere. But here's the key. They won't tell anyone how it works.
Yeah.
And this is the part I love.
Yes.
That when you as a police agency want to find out where someone's phone is, you have to sign a contract, essentially being a non-disclosure agreement.
Right.
Saying you won't even admit
that it exists as a technology.
You won't claim, you won't admit to anyone that you asked the FBI to find the cell phone.
Wow.
So that the FBI can't be called in to testify about
that. That is so scummy.
They'll be like, how'd you find the guy?
Yeah.
We got a tip.
Oh, sorry. I mean, that is awesome. I love the FBI and everything that they do. Anything that I said to the contrary was just me pretending for the benefit of this man. Blame him. Blame Vard. HOGuru. I almost called you by your other name. Sorry.
One of my six names.
Yes.
It's fine.
Vartan. I don't know if there's an attempt. Are you attempting to keep it separate?
No, I don't care. Vartox, popular character from from Superman.
Superman.
Who I've chosen
slash
to pattern myself out.
Himself based
Vartox.
On Sean Connery's Zardos.
Yeah, Zardos. You know, secretly, it was the Wizard of Oz.
Yes. Wow. That's
what Zardoz meant.
It's many layers of copying.
Yeah.
You know, they have,
get it? It's Vartox and Zardoz, and the way he got to Zardoz was Wizard of Oz.
You know, do you think that when they invented Vartox, who is clearly meant to be Sean Connery's character, Zed, from the movie Zardoz, they hadn't yet seen the movie, so
no,
they didn't
just
know.
Seen the poster.
Oh, so they just seen the poster, and they're like, yeah. Oh, this character Connery plays Zardoz, which I always forget too. Like when I'm just kind of generally talking about it in life, I always forget that, you know,
all
Zardoz
logic
is
would suggest that the character was named Zardoz, but he wasn't.
Despite the fact that I love almost more than anything saying my name is Jed and I'm a brutal for Zardoz.
I'm a brutal for Zardoz.
Because it's one of those Connery sentences in a movie where it's like, if you want to get into the Connery vibe, it's like,
my
you
name
need...
is Jed and I'm a brutal for Zardoz.
You need enough S noises.
You do.
Yeah.
To get his lisp going.
Exactly, yeah.
All right, we're on a roof.
Oh, nice.
Oh, I'm supposed to look at something? Mm-hmm. That's the power room?
Guys, if you can hear me, just about at the power room. Should be there soon.
Ish.
Oh, yeah. Nathan Drake, you lovable rogue, you. Mm-hmm. All right, so we have to get from roof to roof, up to that bar, swing across, climb in, power room.
I think you can jump this.
Hopefully we won't
here.
Have to viciously beat anybody when we get there!
Yeah, you did it.
That's still thrilling.
Yep.
Whoa!
Ooh, here we go. That was close.
Thank God he stayed in shape.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Maybe he does a lot of rock climbing.
Well, you know, I mean, he's a professional, you know, treasure diver. Sorry, not treasure. Salvage diver. So I think you got to be in good shape for that.
Yeah.
I mean...
Ah.
Okay. One, two, and let's jump!
Ah, yikes! Ugh. Oh, my goodness
oh,
me.
Oh, crap. No. That's obviously going to fall. We can see it's
uh-oh.
A different color.
Ah.
I can't believe you got away with that.
Hey, sometimes it sounds like she has an English accent, and then other times it sounds like she didn't.
Oh.
Maybe I'm just deaf.
And what about the horse?
Like, clearly
it's
English accent now, right? Or maybe Australian or something.
What did they, There's a Lethal Weapon TV show now.
What?
Are you ready to have your mind blown?
Am I going
to
be sad or happy or what?
Well, here's the weird part. Guess who plays Roger Murtaugh?
Drake?
Actually, you can't, so I'm just going to
okay, yeah, you just tell
and
me.
And it's a jerk thing to ask people to guess. I know that. I hate being asked to guess. I'm terrible at it, so I shouldn't do it. Actually, I will give you such a good clue.
Oh, do that.
That
yeah,
you'll
be
able
fine.
To do it.
That'll be fine.
They cast the star of another Shane Black movie. There's only
is
one
it
other black
a
actor.
Wayans brother?
Yeah.
Is it Damon?
It's Damon Wayans.
Oh, you know what? I think I'm okay with that.
Oh, this Rafe guy? That's the guy who stabbed the warden.
Okay.
Yeah, he's a real dick.
Ah.
All right. So you're saying, but yeah, Damon Wayans.
Damon Wayans. So who is it? Somebody I've heard of playing the part?
I have
of...
no idea who's playing Martin Riggs.
Okay. You don't. You mean you've?
I've never heard of the actor who is playing.
Okay. So they were like, it's Pete Crosenmore, and then you were like,
it is Pete Crosenmore.
Okay.
I mean, you did. You guessed right. It is Pete Crosenmore.
That was a good guess. But what would be the
point in that? Oh, you're such a villain.
Ah. Good stuff.
Big score. A real Jake Gyllenhaal type.
Yes.
Yeah. Real. Real dirtbag, weedy, scummy guy who's only looking out for himself.
Yeah.
Real Gyllenhaal.
Are you talking about the real life Jake Gyllenhaal?
No,
the characters he plays? I was wondering if there's something I didn't know about him.
I know nothing about Jake Gyllenhaal. I'm saying he tends to play these weedy kind of schemers.
He does, yeah. He's related to Maggie Gyllenhaal. I know that about him.
That is true.
Brother and sister.
They are.
Yeah.
Famously.
Yeah.
Okay.
I do hate to break it to you. You are working for an American.
Oh.
We've partnered up on this one.
Oh! Two
Brits. I think.
See, and here's the other army of mercenaries we'll have to kill. So it'll be the army of mercenaries from there.
Yeah.
And then a second army of mercenaries from the drug kingpin.
Yeah. Oh, I guess maybe she's Caribbean. I didn't think of that. That would have made the most sense.
The accent makes sense, actually.
Yeah. She's just got, like, the posh Caribbean accent.
What it is that?
Uh-oh, he's playing dumb.
Nadine, I think your partner here has had too many Bloody Marys.
Uh-oh.
I don't know how you scam your way in here, but if you think about bidding on Avery's Cross, I can tell you exactly how you're going to be.
Wow, what a dirtbag.
Right.
Oh my gosh, he's creating a scene.
Where's the broken glass?
Yeah, good question. Maybe that's how efficient the cleaning staff is. Someone, like, crawled in under their knees, swept that up, and got out.
And I like that they
right
had to
away.
Crawl under their knees so they wouldn't get
in
the way
of the
camera.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're aware people might be filming. From the waist up. Or maybe they have
the
a
worst.
Legless man on a platform with wheels
a
who
trolley.
Specifically does cleaning up things that fall on the floor. They're like, we're helping him, really.
Earlier in the game, there's a time when Nate gets to play Crash Bandicoot.
Oh, really?
And is terrible at it.
I didn't know that the makers of this made Crash
Bandicoot. They did. That's what they used to be famous for. They created Crash Bandicoot.
Huh.
This game kind of turned around how they're thought of.
Well, Crash Bandicoot. I often confuse them with Banjo-Kazooie in my mind.
Because...
they're both animals.
They're both...
That's right. That's how bigoted I am against anthropomorphic animals, or at least the mammal ones. I can't tell them apart.
The mammal ones.
Yeah, like Mickey Mouse, to me, he's no different than Sylvester the cat. They're indistinguishable in my mind.
Yeah, despite being different...
A cat and a mouse from
different companies with different voices.
Yeah.
They really have zero in common.
Oh, yeah.
Other than that, they're indistinguishable.
Pretty
too.
Much, yeah.
Okay, that's fine.
Sylvester with his shrill voice. Hey, you know what, though? If we discuss how Pete from Disney, you know, peg-leg Pete and such. And
yes, famous villain Pete.
Yeah, famous villain Pete. He went through, like, three different kinds of animals that he was. Like, they literally don't care.
I thought he was a dog.
He started out a cat because of Steamboat. Remember Steamboat Willie?
Right.
He's that cat. So he's a cat because it's like he's the enemy of a mouse. He's a cat, right? And then somewhere along the way, because he's clearly the same kind of thing as the Beagle Boys, right?
Yep.
They're like, oh, he's a dog. And then later when they made Goof Troop, they're like, he's a wolf. And he may have been a bear at some point. Like some brief moment, they might have claimed
he was
a bear.
That's insane.
So it's like, he's, as far as I know, the only cartoon character you can say that about. They literally don't care.
And it's
what
weird
because, kind of
you know, you just could have created a new character. No! We have to use beloved character Pegleg Pete, who everyone is emotionally involved and invested in.
Also, not so interesting fact, I found out that on Goof Troop, that's why his wife is Peg, because he was Pegleg Pete, and then his daughter was called Pistol, which always seemed like a really weird name to me, because he was on one occasion Pistol Pete when he was like a cowboy.
I remember him being Pistol Pete.
Yeah, yeah.
That makes perfect sense.
Whereas PJ was just Pete Jr., that's less interesting.
Yeah, didn't he have a third persona they could have gone with?
You'd think they could have had like another one. Like they could have called him Bear Boy, because one time he was a bear. The father, I mean, not the boy.
No, we got that. Yeah, that
would have been a non-awkward name for him.
All right, we did it.
Yeah.
We're in the power room. Time to start just pulling out wires.
Yes.
That's how you disable power, right? You just randomly pull out wires?
Basically what I would do. I'd smash it with a brick.
I would get an axe, which had a wooden handle.
Non-conductive,
see,
right?
See, yeah. Then I would just smack it over and over again until lights went off.
I guess you could just throw off the switches on the breakers. That maybe
but then someone could turn it back on.
What if you threw them off and then glued them down?
I feel like the axe would be still the better solution.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to need a minute before I can reach the panel.
We don't have a minute. Rafe's about to walk out of here with your crew.
Rafe's here?
Uh-oh.
Rafe? Rafe is here?
Yes, Rafe is here.
I know that was the easiest line in the world to predict. But I still predicted it.
Good job.
I don't have that kind of scratch. Sully, we're stealing, remember?
What if he calls my bluff?
He won't.
It's true, that Rafe is too greedy. He won't call his bluff. He'd be like, I've got to one-up him. What if he does have the money? What do they do to you if you bid at an auction? Not a criminal auction where they're going to murder you, but like if you bid, they always act on TV like now you're compelled to. Is that just out of like, you're compelled out of embarrassment? Are you compelled by law? Like, if you're like, I accidentally coughed and now I've bought it.
Well, no, you can't accidentally cough. That's just television.
Yeah, okay.
You have to clearly signal that you are bidding.
Yeah.
Don't worry.
And you're like, I just have a spasm.
Yeah, no. There's no accidental, like in movies, where you nod.
Yeah.
And, fire axe, fire axe, fire axe.
You could vacuum
you want a
it.
Fire axe. Apparently that is made of nothing.
It's an empty shop vac.
Look at that.
Yeah, that is quite light.
Come on,
Drake is
where
really
are your
strong.
Fire axes?
Yikes. You can dump water on it. It doesn't really make any sense. Here
Why
we go.
Why would I dump water on a lock?
Oh, I
crowbar.
Think, sorry, I forgot you're opening the lock. I was thinking the
power turning
it out. Yeah, I forgot about the lock.
All right.
I have very bad short-term memory. Okay.
That's right. I knew it was going to be a tap a lot, so I turned on my turbo button.
Good job.
So I don't have to tap obnoxiously. Mm-hmm. 180,000 euros?
Wow, that's a lot.
Switch them off.
I'm at the switch. You ready?
As I'll ever be, Victor.
Do-do-do-do.
Isn't it crazy?
Whoa!
The world of archaeology and stuff. Like, it's like, oh, we found this old book and it belongs to Shakespeare. How much is it going to go for? 450,000 or something, right? But then it's like Superman 1 is $1 million at least.
Yes.
It was mass produced.
I mean, they are down to 7 left in the world.
That's true, I suppose.
But
yeah.
There's only one of the Shakespeare books.
Exactly. Yeah.
Although people like Superman a lot more than they like Shakespeare.
Do, and people won't admit that because they're jerks.
Yeah, they like to lie.
Yeah. Then I should sell it for 500,000. Ooh, I shall sell. The backup power will come on shortly. Oh my.
It's gone.
Wow. I bet it wasn't Sully, though. I bet it was like some other person.
No, but he wants them to think it was Sully, so they'll chase the wrong guy.
Oh, yeah.
Uh-oh.
Oh, wait, no, of course it was, his brother.
Yeah, it was
I forgot. I told you.
You forgot what the plan was?
Tell me you got the I was too busy talking about whatever it was we were talking about that I've also forgotten, so sorry.
It's okay.
He ruined everything.
All right.
Okay.
I will do that. Hey, you can search Victor all you want. He won't have it. All right. Jumping on rooftops, parkour style. It's not just for Assassin's Creed games anymore.
No.
Oh, darn!
Gosh, they got an Assassin's Creed movie coming out. This seems kind of redundant or something. Like, it's like already kind of like a movie, isn't it?
And investigating what they think they saw.
Yeah.
Ooh, and then, okay.
Now, I haven't played the Assassin's Creed game, so, like, I'm, I guess, amongst the 1% of people on Earth who haven't.
Well, video gamers. Obviously, there are many people who don't actively have video game systems who haven't played Assassin's Creed.
Sure. But it's like a lot of people have. And,
it's a very popular franchise.
My brother's played a lot of it, so I know a bit about it that way. And I understand that none of the games actually have been set during the Spanish Inquisition.
Oh, wait, am I supposed to kill this guy?
I think so. Just kill him. Go ahead and do it. Murder this man. The crime of protecting artifacts. Oh my
god! He went all the way down.
Yeah, so Drake just kills people.
Yeah, Drake just killed the guy.
Yeah, like he's basically a serial killer. In fact, he's killed a lot more people than most serial killers.
You know, I counted it up for a Morbid Gamer article, and it's like 1,200 people.
Oh my god!
For those first three games.
So Nate Drake is if he were a real life person, would be probably have the highest kill count of any human
who has ever lived. Yes,
like ever.
Like even those weird World War II snipers who shot like 900 people.
Yeah.
This guy would be higher.
Yeah. Or if there's like maybe like some sort of Barbaro from the Age of Magic that we don't know about or whatever, right? Like who lived between the times when the oceans drank Atlantis. Like maybe if that's a real thing, then maybe one of those guys might have killed
All right, people. So you were saying that they should do one set during the Inquisition?
No, I was just saying that's when the movie is set, and I was going to say, but apparently none of the games, like, I mean, if you had asked me about the game series from my limited knowledge of it and, like, seeing
stuff,
I would have assumed that that made sense. But, yeah, my brother's like, no, none of them were set during the Spanish Inquisition. They, you know, they take place in kind of similar oeuvres and so on or whatever.
Well, I understand why they're setting the movie there.
Yeah.
No one would expect that.
One of the ads says that. I swear one of them says, like... No, it can't possibly say nobody expects the Spanish Inquisition.
Can it?
It says something.
All right, here we go. Is there a guy in there, or are we good?
I'm
not seeing a flashlight moving around in there.
There's a light moving on the behind. You see what I'm saying?
Let's do it. Inside. Yup.
Okay. Stay down.
Yeah, you know, because murdering people with my hands is proving so time-consuming.
Like a bust of somebody.
So it's set during the Spanish Inquisition, but most of it is set during the present day.
Yeah,
with Fassbender fast bending it up in the present day, and then going into a machine, a video game machine, that lets him see the past,
mm-hmm.
where they hid a piece of Eden, which is a thing that
made
the
by
first
aliens.
Men.
Right. The first men, yes. Yeah.
No, you didn't see me.
Ah. So is it going to be released simultaneous to the new X-Men as well? Will Fassbender be competing against Fassbender?
No, I don't know when the Assassin's Creed game is coming out.
Ooh.
I will use tall grass to stay hidden from enemies.
Were you telling me that the new X-Men, because of the success of Deadpool, was the new X-Men that tried to, like, insert all the comedy scenes?
No, that was Suicide Squad.
Oh, Suicide Squad. Okay, because it looked like I saw an ad for the new X-Men, and it almost looked like they were trying to kind of do that, too. Like, let's put in the funny scenes, which... they hadn't in some earlier trailers, and it didn't look like there were too many funny scenes again, like, you know.
Yeah, no, Suicide Squad, they went back to reshoot,
yeah,
like, 30 minutes of the movie to make it less depressing.
Wow.
because Zack Snyder has been taken out of control of DC. They have wrested it from his evil claws.
Hey, let's
with any luck, the Snyderverse is over.
I was gonna say, let's pretend there had never been. This is a stupid question. Why am I even asking? But let's pretend that there had never been a Watchmen movie made by Zack Snyder, and he'd only made the various other things that he'd made. Okay.
Well, he still made 300.
Yes, he did.
That's true. Like, that's what got him these jobs. It wasn't Watchmen. Making 300.
And let's say that had happened. Brian Singer or Zack Snyder? Do you have a who do you have more of a mad on for? Why am I even asking this question? I know the
answer. Zack Snyder. He made
300. 300.
He made Sucker Punch.
Yeah, you're right. I don't know why I asked that question. It's like Brian Singer is really the only bad thing
he made.
He did
Valkyrie.
Just like,
he made The Usual Suspects. I like Brian Singer.
He made good movies.
He made good movies. Zack Snyder's never made a good movie. Yes, people like Sucker Punch because they're wrong.
Yeah.
Can I knock over that?
Maybe I'm just picking on him too much because I saw some of Superman last night on TV and I'm like, wow, it was less good than I remembered. But I didn't
How did
the
you
whole
think
thing.
It was good at all?
I didn't really remember it as being good. I was just, I think, like, what happened is we went and saw that movie and I was excited to
that
see on the big
Superman
screen a Superman movie that was pretending that it was part of the original, you know, bunch of movies, and there was some Superman.
Oh, you think
about
Superman
playing.
Returns?
Superman
I don't know why I thought you said Man
no,
of Steel.
No. Yeah, because that wasn't Brian Singer. That was.
No, yeah, of course. But no, Superman Returns. You're right. I was too hard on it at the time. You know.
Oh.
Oh no.
Scusi.
Oh look, someone nearly slit her throat one time. We didn't.
Yeah.
I didn't notice that before.
Well, neither are you. But I'll tell you what. I won't tell anyone if you don't.
You have something I want.
Crazy murderer.
Well, I'm flattered, but I'm afraid I'm spoken for. If you'll excuse me.
Ow!
Uh-oh, she used that kind of nose bridge palm thing.
Hurts. It's some CQC nonsense.
Yeah. Uh-oh. She means business.
Yep.
She's going to do mixed martial arts crap or something.
Yep.
Ow. I wonder if this will all be cinema, or will you have a chance to try to kick her ass?
Well, let's find out.
Yeah.
By playing the game.
Yeah.
Just remember, I didn't want to do this.
Let's see what you've got.
Brawler versus MMA nonsense. She knows who he is.
My reputation precedes me.
Don't telegraph some.
I don't remember how to do the fighting stuff.
Oh, boy. That might not be good. Oh, there you punch her in the leg.
Oof.
Nice try.
I gave you that one.
Ow.
Oh, my gosh.
I legit don't remember how to do the fighting stuff. Like, they did a whole training thing, then I went off and played Doom for a week.
Oh, boy.
You know how many artifacts I've collected over the years?
He's being wry.
More specific.
Let me see if I can clarify.
It's funny, but she already asked for the cross.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Ow!
I look, I'm still a little jet lagged. How about we just call it even?
I think you might not be able to bargain your way out of this one.
Okay.
Too bad you can't hit her with a thing.
Yeah, hitting her with a thing, would be great.
Yeah.
I feel like maybe I'm not supposed to be winning this fight.
Probably not. I think this is all part of the story. You're not a chiropractor.
Being a smartass has gotten me this far in life.
Yeah.
Why quit now?
Ow!
Goodness.
Alright, wait. It's in my back pocket.
It's obviously not.
Where is it?
Right there.
Oh. No.
What? She's not good at planning.
Yeah.
If he had the cross,
she'd not
find
out now.
Disastrously bad for her.
All right,
she can't control her anger.
Well, she does have a mercenary army.
Yeah.
That's not the bailiwick of stable individuals.
No.
You know? Let's not forget that a guy took his car mirror light empire, and said, I'm going to build a mercenary army with this.
Is this Blackwater
That's
now
the story
renamed
of,
X?
Blackwater.
X. Is it called X? Or
I think
am I
it's called
it
She?
Or
X-E,
Z? Or Z?
Or
it's like the Greek Z or X or something. Or,
yeah.
No, that would be Zeta. Would be. Z, I guess.
Yeah, I think it's XE, which is pronounced she or G or something.
I think about letters of the.
Anyway, he's horrible.
Yes.
The point. Like, let's
we,
take
we can assume that he probably would pitch someone through a window in a fit of anger, is what you're saying.
100%.
Yeah.
His name, I mean, I'm not saying he's a real life supervillain, but his name is Eric Prince.
Come on, how can that. basically, that was like a self-fulfilling prophecy when they were like, hey, our kid is named Eric Prince.
How do I... Do you see a place I can go here? What am I missing?
You can't go up on that metal hangy doohickey.
Like, your arm stretches out when you
reach. What
about
the higher ledge right there? Can you reach that? Nope. Can you jump reach it? No? Oh, there you can. Okay. Oh, no.
Damn.
Don't worry, he meant to do that. Okay. Oh, hey, that's kind of convenient, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's nice.
It's,
good thing that was made of, like, pretty heavy steel, that hand.
Yeah. It's a real Indiana Jones gong situation.
Yeah. They should throw tiles at those guys.
I'm gonna shoot people from a...
Oh.
It's a terrible idea.
That's so Drake.
Did you just say that's so Drake?
Yeah, but it totally is, isn't it?
It is. Oh my god.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, that's so Raven.
Yep. It's the future I can see.
Alright, let's reload.
Okay.
Thank you.
Right.
Yeah, how, though, is my question.
How are you going to get out of this one? There you go.
Oh, I climb up to that thing. All right, that actually made sense.
Okay.
All right, Drake. It's time to Nathan your way into the hearts of millions. Assassin's Creed just seems like a weird thing to make a movie out of.
Because it's a lot of these video games now, it seems kind of pointless given that they're already like
so cinematic.
Trying to be like movies. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. They actually, here's the crazy part. So they made, on stealth, hold L2. Oh. Cool. Mark. That way I can find them later.
I mean, really, the fun of like video game movies, and none of them were ever really good. But you know, they used to take things that were so minimalist that they could like kind of really like go any which way with it. And you'd be like, oh, what are they going to do with the idea of Mario? And the answer was a pretty bad film. But
was of course Blade Runner.
Yeah, I guess that's what they thought that was.
Well, they built the Blade Runner city quite obviously.
It basically, it was the Blade Runner city.
You know?
And, King Koopa was an evolved Dino Man.
Yep.
Yeah, from another dimension.
And then he devolved into a Dino Man because they used a Devolvo Ray on him.
It was odd. It was not just a, it wasn't, like, simply acceptable to be like, there's other dimensions. It was, another dimension was created when, like, the,
The meteor hit the Earth.
Yeah. They felt the need for there to have been...
They both killed the dinosaurs. It didn't kill the dinosaurs. It moved them into their own dino dimension.
Yeah, it was an odd choice.
And they all evolved into humans for some reason.
I wonder if they were hoping initially that they would have, like, then-popular, the series Dinosaurs-style Jim Henson puppet people to be King Koopas.
Probably. Oh, crap.
As opposed to Dennis Hopper. No.
And one Lance Q. Henrington.
Yeah.
That's right. I don't know how to say his name.
Was Lance Henrickson
was he
the King
Koopa?
Yeah. Mushroom guy. Yeah.
Mushroom King, whose name eludes me.
Yeah. In the comic books, he was just called the King.
Oh.
I consider them canonical. The Mario comics
as you should.
Are canonical, yeah. Right. For Mario.
I feel like we're safe sneaking in
here,
right?
Yes.
Okay, so that's the exit. Crap!
Ah!
Oh, well, this is bad.
I guess it was King Toadstool.
Come to think of it, yes, because we called her Princess Toadstool, didn't we?
I still do.
Yeah, take that, people who want to call her Peach.
Yeah. 20 years later.
What? I was trying to grab that second ledge!
Goodness me, that was brutal.
That was unfair, right?
Oh, yeah. Usually he's such a good grabber.
Yeah. I'm sure that was on me, but I'm still annoyed. Sorry, you're about to get kung fu.
Sneaking, there we go.
Uh-huh. Oh, your buddy saw that. So now he's also going to get kung fu.
Yeah, but he's definitely dead.
To use the vernacular, you know he dead.
Yeah. Thank you, Chris Tucker.
Oh, Chris Tucker. You know there was a Rush Hour TV show last year?
What?
I know.
What are these things happening? I don't know.
I just found out they were, I just saw news last week that it was canceled.
What?
I'm like... It existed?
That happened? Who was Jackie Chan?
I have no idea.
Did they take, like, a less expensive, younger, like, Hong Kong martial arts star that we don't know about and put him in the show?
I guarantee they didn't.
Probably not, no.
I am shooting a lot of people today.
You know, don't make TV shows out of things that... Like, see, a Jackie Chan movie, the hook of almost any Jackie Chan movie is that it has Jackie Chan.
That he's going to Jackie Chan up the place.
Exactly. He's going to do stunts and jump
around. Unless you're going to have someone Sammo hung up the place.
Yeah, what's the point?
What is the point?
I mean, I guess there was that Jackie Chan cartoon where they licensed the rights to his name and had a guy do, like, a Jackie Chan voice.
Yeah, Jackie Chan Adventures, I believe it was called.
Yeah, but, I mean, that was animated anyway, so, you know, you can have him jump off stuff and so on. It doesn't, you know, you're not limited by the skills of a...
By the way,
being.
I love that he's, Sam is like, I'm pinned down here, and I'm offering you no, like, suggestion of where I am or how to get there.
No.
So, thanks for that.
Oh, here we go.
Sam Drake with the fake name.
Oh, boy.
Are we hearing Italian people yelling?
I think so. Is that where this auction is taking place, Italy?
I think it's Spain.
Spain, okay.
Okay, that's two dudes. Who may be clones. Maybe. I didn't get a good look at the first guy. Kung Fu!
It would be great if you started your own mercenary army and due to the, you know, not ready availability of inexpensive cloning technology, you insisted on only hiring people who like,
look identical. Functionally identical.
Yeah, functionally identical. And you prized that over their actual skill. Like, It's not like you're hiring people who have zero skill, but you're like...
No, of course not.
That's very important to you. It's like there are a lot of better people that could be working here, but they're not all identical in a video game-like way, and that's what you
like,
were going
no, for. No, I need my guys to have a theme. A visual theme. All right, let's do it. Let's assume he's over here
gosh,
somewhere.
You're using your gun to do that. I've always wondered, is that, you know, safe at all?
No.
Or maybe he wasn't using his gun. Maybe he's just holding it. Oh, my gosh.
And he landed exactly where his brother was.
Wow, that is convenient.
Yep. Convenient and then some. So are these her guards or are these the company guards?
Unclear at this point.
I'm doing weird piecemeal shooting as if I've forgotten I have a submachine gun. And it's not as if. I literally did forget I had a machine gun. Now I'm back to pistol. And it's going awesomely.
There's another
assault rifle.
Yeah.
That should help.
There we go.
Yeah, that definitely made life a lot easier.
That's better.
Or for him, death!
Ah!
See?
Clever.
Made death a lot easier is what I was saying. Jesus, Sam, get down! I don't want to accidentally shoot you. I mean, I don't think you can, but, you know. Which way are we going again?
Am I the only one not keeping track of getting the heck out of here,
but
as to
via
how,
which direction?
Let's just run around.
So rack room?
Run around. When people try to stop you from leaving, that probably means it's the way you're supposed to be going.
We might actually be supposed to... Oh my god! Wait. Yeah, no, I think we're supposed to kill everybody. Yes!
Yeah, you're meant to
murder glass statue... The glass statue. The ice statue was destroyed. Let's destroy the other one, too. That's awesome.
Nice. I was trying to think of an ice to see you style pun other than ice to see you, but I couldn't.
So, for the record, Rainier Wolf Castle.
Yes.
What do you call it?
Schwarzenegger parody.
Schwarzenegger parody.
Yeah.
Schwarzenegger Monkey, everything but the name.
Yep.
Said ice to see you in The Simpsons.
Yeah.
And then Schwarzenegger actually said ice to see you.
In the Batman movie?
In Batman and Robin.
You know, I can't remember.
Or am I just remembering that wrong?
I remember recently having this exact conversation with my brother as to whether or not my brother's like, he did. And I'm like, no, I think I wanted him to, but he didn't.
Yeah, it's tough because, you know, people get quotes wrong all the time because they want it to have been some way. And I understand that. I do it myself. Mm-hmm. Which is why I'm never super sure of any quote except for The Simpsons quotes.
Yeah.
Which is why I have...
by virtue of having watched it.
Well, no, what I'm just saying, which I have studied the way 12th century monks studied the Bible.
Exactly. So you've really committed this to memory.
Yeah.
So.
No, I'm fairly confident about my. I call him Gambler.
Yeah.
And now it's time to steal your mother from his now. See, I'm already hemming and hawing on it after that buildup.
Steal
your mother from his neon claws.
Yeah. He did say that.
He did say that.
He may have said the time has come, but I don't think
I don't
would
think
put my knowledge
the time has come.
Against yours in that case.
I think it's now it's time to steal your mother from his neon claws. Luckily, the bad guys don't have access to cars. They do have access to a lot of guns, though.
They do. We should have spent more money on cars, I told
you. What were we thinking with all these guns?
Oh, my gosh.
And that's the guy who was crucified next to one Jesus.
I believe so. Who would have been a thief like Drake?
Exactly.
Irony, or not irony? I'm not sure which.
All right.
What? It's empty.
What?
such an asshole.
He is, though.
He likes to fool around with them.
Right. He can... Crossbones. Very good.
That is a very good sign. Pirates.
Sort of pirate code.
Today you will join me in paradise.
That doesn't sound good.
Well, Jesus said to St. Dismas on the
cross. Okay.
What about these numbers here? What do you make of this?
Some kind of code or a phone number.
Hilarious.
The dates. Huh? 1659.
It's the year Avery was born.
1699.
Let me guess. The year he died.
By most accounts, yeah, but it means we have date of birth, date of death, and paradise. Which means we're looking for Avery's grave.
St. Dismas's Cathedral.
But didn't we already do that?
Scotland, or?
Yeah.
Hasn't Rafe been scouring that site for ages already?
Yeah, the cathedral. See these
not
symbols?
The graveyard outside of it.
These are found on old Scottish.
Why would he not check for them, dig up the guy's grave just to be safe?
Unless it's not.
This place is really unusual. Here's the cathedral.
There are weirdly large numbers of sniper nests. In an amazing coincidence. He's been, to use the vernacular, digging in the wrong place.
Yeah.
You do realize that Rafe knows you're coming.
Yeah, we can deal with that when we get there.
That psycho would like nothing but...
You're terrible at this.
Plus he's got Nadine and a whole army to back him up.
Yeah, but he doesn't have this. The biggest pirate treasure of all time is within our grasp.
I thought this was about saving
Well, it's both, clearly.
Well, come on, it's both, right?
Thank you.
The treasure so we can save Sam.
How much of the treasure do the drug dealer want? All of it?
Half of it.
No, half of it.
See, he's not unreasonable.
Wow, and he's like an evil, you know, he could just demand the whole thing, really.
He could.
With all that you two have been through together.
Presumably.
But they're friends.
You are not giving her enough credit.
I can't take that chance.
Of course you can.
Why? She's gone on all his adventures. I don't understand.
Literally all of the adventures.
Did he decide he was going to stop having adventures, or was she like, hey...
No, he decided to stop having adventures.
So it's not even like she was like, you must promise
she's
me.
She's like, go to Malaysia and find a boat. It's fine.
So what's he lying about? Is it maybe she really dislikes the brother? Is that it? Or?
Oh, they don't know each other.
Oh, well, see, it doesn't even make any sense.
Hey, it's me,
Uh-oh. He's quit drinking.
Something on your mind, dear?
Look, I realize it couldn't have been easy. All those years away.
How do you tie a bow tie?
And I'm sorry.
I don't know.
Probably shouldn't have asked.
Never
you.
Been invited to a bow tie event. I think I wore one
I've
to prom.
Gone, I've gone to many, and I have a, you know, just a
clip-on bow tie.
Well, no, it's one you put wrap around. And,
You know who could answer this question? Louis Farrakhan.
Why are you here, Victor?
That's 1 hour and 17 minutes until our first mention of Louis Farrakhan. I win the bat.
There we go.
What the hell did that mean?
Yeah, I will. Okay. I love you too.
Bye. Oh, Nathan Drake. The secret is he's going to turn out to be Dracula. That's why he's called Drake.
Of course, yeah. I should have figured that out. That's the family that he's related to.
Yeah,
historical
was,
Dracula.
They thought it was your Francis Drake's all along. It was actually Dracula.
Who will also turn out to be a vampire.
Yeah. That's why he started calling himself Drake, to hide the fact that he was a Dracula.
Ah, that's why we've never seen him out and about during the day.
Not once.
No, ever.
Oh, Nathan Drake. Famous vampire. Mm-hmm. Famous treasure-hunting vampire.
Ooh. Look at
that. Oh. Rafe's really going all in, isn't he?
The heather.
Well,
the heather. The fields of heather.
Because we are going to have that graveyard all to ourselves.
Yeah, I feel like the guys working at that thing with cranes would not bring out the cranes to wreck the place before searching the next giant cathedral to the right.
You would think, that that would be...
Yeah, this is a bit of a flaw writing-wise, I would say.
Hey, Nate.
Yeah.
Maybe the other one is haunted.
I have spent 15 years searching for this guy's treasure. Did you check his grave? No. That never occurred to me for 1 second. Only when I have completely demolished this place brick by brick will I then go and look for his grave. Are we being too sarcastic, or come on?
I think that's a fair point.
All right. It's obviously not where his treasure is. It's where a clue to the treasure is. Do you know nothing about treasure hunting?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so we're going to take a break now and come back for our first ever live edition of the Manhunting Project.
Nice.
I know, I'm very excited, but I've been the Hidden Object Guru.
And I've been the Night Dawg.
We want to thank you for watching.
Yeah.
And let you know that we'll be back for more video game really soon. Both the Manhunting Project and then more stuff next week, where we're going to devote the entire show to playing video games and talking about Hamilton.
Yes, we will.
So you probably have to have watched Hamilton.
I will definitely by then.
Just FYI.
I mean, I've heard stories.
All right.
Trust me. Me
too. Oh my God.